Want to speak real Turkish from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at TurkishClass101.com.
Ah, maybe first you can pretend like you know the person from somewhere, okay? That always works.
Nice to meet you.
Hey. Wait, wait, that's English.
Yeah.
Hola, Maca. ¿Me has dicho que dices Anja? ¿Es correcta?
Very sexy inside.
Mexican?
No,
Mexican sounds good.
Is it Spanish?
No.
No.
Va, que llegiré una frase. D'accord?
Yes.
Portuguese?
No.
So maybe it's Spain. Spanish, like...
it's in Spain.
How do they say it? Maybe I don't know how to say it in English. Catalanese?
Yeah.
Really?
Catalan.
Oh, really?
Hola. ¿Cómo estás? Hola, Max. ¿Cómo estás? La verdad es que te iba a tirar un chamuyo barato, pero te vi los ojos y no sé, te quiero invitar a salir, te quiero para algo serio. La verdad que no soy de hacer estas cosas, es raro en mí. Pero desde el momento en el que te vi, estoy sintiendo cosas que antes no sentía. No sé qué me está pasando. Y no sé si es tu voz o tu sonrisa, pero me parece que tenemos que ir a tomar algo juntos. Así que lo que voy a hacer es darte mi número de teléfono, me vas a escribir, tal vez nos vamos a enamorar, no sé, veremos qué pasa. ¿Está bien?
No sé.
I know.
Wow, this is like love confession.
I have to admit that it was like kind of romantic, like the pronunciation and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But like, yeah, the content is a bit cheesy. Yeah. Oh, sorry about that.
Is it Spanish language, right?
I don't know, you think so?
Yeah.
Es castellano, exactamente.
我喜欢跟你在一起的感觉。我能请你喝杯东西吗？你怎么那么可爱？
It was so sudden, I don't know.
This is easy.
Are you willing to come to my place afterwards? Yeah, just like to be kind of like spice things up a bit.
Like it's Mandarin.
Yes.
How come you know?
I've got a lot of Chinese friends.
Aww.
라면먹고갈래?
Okay.
No. This is obvious for me.
It means, do you want to drop by my house and eat instant noodle with me?
This sounds like something like Chinese or Vietnamese to me.
Do you really use it? I mean, well, or it's just like...
This line is from a movie, so actually everyone knows. Yeah, ta.
That's it.
Yeah, ta.
Korean, right?
Okay, so let's say... Korean.
But please remember this line. Okay. 라면 먹고 갈래?
라면 먹고 갈래?
This line is usually used by female.
Oh.
So it's like, I will
try. Today I will try.
Yeah. Okay. 라면 먹고 갈래?
라면 먹고 갈래?
Yeah.
どこかでお会いしたことありますか?
ないと思います。
今度一緒にご飯でもどうですか?
まだ食べた。
まだ食べた。It means no, maybe. I didn't expect the answer.
It was like one way. Japanese.
僕が必ず君を守るから。
Oh, I got excited.
And now I get really shy because she understands.
I understand you.
It means like I'm going to protect you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, they don't say in real world.
Yeah. But sometimes you see drama. In drama. Yeah, drama. But it's too romantic,
yeah.
I think.
I want to give a message from here to the world. Mm-hmm. Don't watch so much drama. Come and experience real life first, right?
That's true.
Du är så vacker. Så det ger solen en anledning att skina.
Wow.
Wow. This one is hard.
You're so beautiful. Mm-hmm. You give the sun a reason to shine.
Wow.
It doesn't look like something European or... I feel like it might be indie.
Oh, yeah, this is a good one. Dina läppar smakar som vin och ikväll vill jag bli berusad.
Okay, like it looks so different to me right now. Like I feel like it's something European right now and like something Germanic, but not German.
Hint.
What's the letter it starts with?
The letter it starts with? S.
Can you say it again? This one?
Yeah.
Not because I like the compliment.
Yeah. I'll say it as many times as you like. Om det hade varit kriminellt att vara snygg, hade du fått livstid.
Okay, this is like something European because I hear no criminal.
Du är så, you said, right?
Du är så.
Du är så. Is it a European language?
Yes.
Swedish?
Holy cow.
Swedish, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know, because I have friends from Sweden.
Ah.
Hello again.
Oh, you're a beautiful girl.
You are a girl.
What? I thought it was a girl.
What, really? Hello.
Oh, hello.
Hey.
Difficult.
Usually I've got some bad stereotypes about like Spanish, but the Spanish one was quite good, I think. But that's not the winner. To me, like, okay. I think it was Korean, mainly because I couldn't understand like what it meant.
I don't know. I just think Spanish sounds maybe the most sexiest of the languages I've heard today. Yeah, I didn't know much of Catalan, the sound of that, and that was really nice as well. Now, since my husband is Korean, Korean was attractive, I think, because that's why maybe I fell in love with him, right? But also, it's really hard to decide because Castellano and also the Canton language, it sounds also very attractive. I don't know, maybe it's because of their tonation. I don't know why, but even though I don't know the meaning, it sounds like very natural, very confident. So I like that language too.
Herkese merhaba, ben Zehra. Sevgililer Günü, Aziz Valentin Günü'nden esinlenilmiştir. 14 Şubat'ta kutlanır. Sevgililer ve eşlerin birbirlerine verdikleri değer, sevgi, aşk ve tutkuyu göstermek için kutlanan bir gündür. Bu derste, Türkiye'de Sevgililer Günü'nün nasıl kutlandığına dair bilgiler edineceksiniz. Ve Türk tarihi boyunca sevgili kavramı ile ilgili ilginç şeyler öğreneceksiniz. Osmanlı'da değişik renk ve şekillerdeki oyalı mendillerin ne anlama geldiklerini biliyor musunuz? Cevabı bu videonun sonunda göstereceğiz. Türkiye'de Sevgililer Günü klasik anlamda kutlanır. Sevgililer birbirlerine hediyeler alır, aşk mesajlarıyla dolu kartlar yazarlar. Çiçek, çikolata, kalpli oyuncaklar genelde popüler hediyeler seçenekleri arasındadır. Deniz kenarı gibi manzaralı restoranlarda romantik bir akşam yemeği için yer ayırtılır. Bu günü evde baş başa akşam yemeği yiyerek ve film izleyerek geçiren çiftler de çoktur. Bugüne önem veren bazı çiftler, Sevgililer Günü'nde evlenmeyi veya evlilik teklif etmeyi tercih ederler. Bugün Hristiyan kökenli bir kutlama olduğundan bazı geleneksel kişiler tarafından uygun bulunmamaktadır. Osmanlı'da ise sevgililik günümüze göre çok daha kapalı yaşanırdı. Sadabat, İstanbul'da Osmanlı'nın en gözde mesire yeriydi. Burada genç aşıklar buluşur, eğlenceler tertiplenirdi. Günlük hayatta kalabalık içinde konuşması ayıp olan kadınlar hislerini oyalı mendilleriyle ifade ederlerdi. Dede Korkut destanındaki Deli Dumrul efsanesine göre yiğit ve tez canlı olan Deli Dumrul, ölüm meleği Azrail'e meydan okur. Öfkelenen Azrail, onun canını almak için gelir. O da kendisinin yerine canını verecek birini aramaya başlar. Annesi ve babası canlarını vermek istemezler ama sevgilisi canını vermeyi kabul eder. Dumrul'un sevgilisinin fedakarlığından etkilenen Tanrı, anne ve babanın kalan günlerini onlara ekleyerek onları bağışlar. Türklerde anne ve babaya verilen değerle tezat gibi görünen Deli Dumrul destanını kendi bağlamında değerlendirmek gerekir. Türk kavimleri göçebe olduklarından neslin devamını sağlayacak gençlerin birlikteliği önemlidir. Ve şimdi size deminki quizin cevabını vereceğim. Osmanlı'da değişik renk ve şekillerdeki oyalı mendillerin ne anlama geldiklerini biliyor musunuz? Mendil, oyalarında sarı ve çiçek dizisi mutsuzluğu veya ümitsiz bir aşkı, beyaz yaseminler, kadının evli olduğunu, sümbül, nişanlı olduğunu, yaban gülü, erkeğinin uzakta oluşunu, biber, kocasıyla arasının iyi olmadığını, pembe çiçekli oya ise kadının hamileliğini gösterirdi.
Hi everybody, I'm Celine and I'm back with another Turkish class. So today's topic is top 10 phrases you'll need for a date in Turkey. Okay, let's start. It's gonna be a fun lesson. Benimle yemeğe çıkar mısın? Would you like to go out to a dinner with me? Benimle yemeğe çıkar mısın? Benimle yemeğe çıkar mısın? Would you like to go out to a dinner with me? So, I don't know the other countries, but usually in Turkey, guys ask the girls to go out to a date. Usually, but I think maybe like recently it's changing, of course. Maybe girls are also asking. But this sentence, I usually hear from the guys. But this has to be like, how should I say? Maybe you're talking for a long time. Not long time, maybe you knew each other well. You talked before and then maybe you can ask this. Like, don't just say this to anyone you just met or you had crush. Just first, maybe you talk, you know each other, and then you can say, would you like to go out to a dinner with me? And I don't know the answer of the person, but yes. Bu hafta sonu boş musun? Are you free this weekend? Bu hafta sonu boş musun? Bu hafta sonu boş musun? Are you free this weekend? So if you hear this sentence, probably you will think, this person has some feelings for me. Bu hafta sonu boş musun? So, which means that person will ask you to go out. So, if you say yes, evet, bu hafta sonu boşum. Yes, I'm free this weekend. İşim yok. I have nothing special to do. İşim yok. But if you want to reject the person, then no, I'm sorry. Hayır. Özür dilerim. Özür dilerim. I'm sorry. I have things to do this weekend. Bu hafta sonu işim var. İşim var. Which means I have things to do this weekend. Çok sevimlisin. You're so cute. Çok sevimlisin. You're so cute. Çok sevimlisin. Oh, it's so romantic here. They usually use it for girls. But I think girls actually use it for guys too. Like if they say something funny or something, you know, like joyful, then girls can also say çok sevimlisin to a guy. We actually have another way to say you're cute. It's çok tatlısın. Girls will probably say like, oh, çok tatlısın ya, like with this tone of voice. To guys, it's just like çok sevimlisin. Almost no difference, I think. Çok sevimlisin, çok tatlısın, It's really like, it's a really nice way to flirt, you know? It's really a cute sentence. Harika görünüyorsun. You look great. Harika görünüyorsun. You look great. Harika görünüyorsun. So it means you met with the person, right? And now you see this person in front of you, and maybe you would like to compliment to the dress or to the clothes that person is wearing. So you can say harika görünüyorsun. Or, like, let's say you will say something to your girlfriend. This clothes looks good on you. This dress looks good on you. You can say, bu elbise sana çok yakışmış. Bu elbise means this dress looks good on you. Sana çok yakışmış. Harika görünüyorsun. Bu elbise sana çok yakışmış. It will be perfect. Çok güzel bir akşam oldu. That was a great evening. Çok güzel bir akşam oldu. Çok güzel bir akşam oldu. That was a great evening. Okay, so the dinner is over. Now you're just, maybe you're just about to separate. Ah, that was a great evening. Then you say, çok güzel bir akşam oldu. And I think it's better to thank the person after you say, çok güzel bir akşam oldu. Just go with teşekkür ederim. Seni arayacağım. I'll call you. Seni arayacağım. Seni arayacağım. I'll call you. Well, you can use the sentence I'll call you, and grammatically it's not wrong. But I think it will sound like you will not call the person. So it's better to say the exact time. You can say, I'll call you tomorrow then. So, yarın seni arayacağım. It's better and it will sound like you're really into that person and you really mean to call again. So just say the exact time, like I'll call you tomorrow morning, I'll call you after I get back to home or whatever. But just say the time, I think it's better. Seni eve bırakayım. I will drive you home. Seni eve bırakayım. Seni eve bırakayım. I'll drive you home. Oh, so you have a car. I'll call you tomorrow. No, okay. Well, I think it's really kind of you to say that. Seni eve bırakayım. Or you can maybe just say, can I drive you home? Like, you can ask first. So say like this. Seni eve bırakayım mı? Seni eve bırakabilir miyim? Which means, can I drive you home? Like, you're asking the permission. Seni eve bırakabilir miyim? Seni eve bırakabilir miyim? It will be more, like, romantic, I think. So I think in Turkey, usually guys ask in the first date to drive you home. It's very general, it's very common. Like, can I drive you home? But I'm not sure if the person always accepts. I think it really depends on the person. Sometimes they do, if the date goes well, but sometimes they don't. But usually you hear the question, like, can I drive you home? Seni tekrar görebilir miyim? Can I see you again? Seni tekrar görebilir miyim? Seni tekrar görebilir miyim? Can I see you again? I like that one. That's perfect. It's not very pushy, not very like full of self-confident, very kind. Can I see you again? Like, thank you for tonight. Can I see you again? Seni tekrar görebilir miyim? It's very gentle, I think. Pass from me. Başka bir yere gidelim mi? Shall we go somewhere else? Başka bir yere gidelim mi? Başka bir yere gidelim mi? Nereye gidiyoruz? Ona bağlı tabii ki. Shall we go somewhere else? Where? It depends on where. So, for example, after your dinner, that your dinner is over, and maybe you would like to walk in the beach after the dinner. Let's say you live somewhere close to beach. And then, shall we go to the beach after our dinner is over? You can ask. But if you just directly say, başka bir yere gidelim mi? Then probably the person will ask you where, right? It depends on where. So, just be more specific, like about everything, about time, about the place you go. It will be always better, I think. Burayı nasıl buldun? What do you think of this place? Burayı nasıl buldun? Burayı nasıl buldun? What do you think of this place? Or, you don't need to say burayı. Nasıl buldun? What do you think? But instead of burayı, if you put the name of the place you go, like restoranı nasıl buldun? What do you think about the restaurant? Sinema. Sinemayı nasıl buldun? It's also fine. So nasıl buldun? This phrase, you can use it with anything. So anywhere you go, you can ask this question. Nasıl buldun? And this is the end. Oh, I'm so sad. I'm sure you're sad too this time. So I hope to see you guys in the next video. And in meantime, if you would like to learn Turkish more, please don't forget to visit our website, TurkishClass101.com. I hope to see you guys in the next video. Please take care and don't forget to use these phrases if you're trying to date with a Turkish guy or girl. See you guys. Bye-bye. Hi, everyone. I'm Celine from TurkishClass101.com. Today, we have a very romantic topic, and it is 10 most romantic ideas for a date. Let's see. Mum ışığında akşam yemeği. Candlelit dinner. Mum ışığında bir akşam yemeği sırasında evlenme teklifi etmeyi düşünüyorum. Mum ışığında bir akşam yemeği sırasında evlenme teklifi etmeyi düşünüyorum. I'm planning to propose during a candlelit dinner. Wow, very romantic. So, yeah, then it means you're dating for a long time, so it's not a first date. But I think for a first date, it's also not a bad idea to go to a candlelit dinner. Why not? Uzun bir yürüyüşe çıkmak. To go for a long walk. Sahilde uzun bir yürüyüşe çıkmak ister misin? Sahilde uzun bir yürüyüşe çıkmak ister misin? Would you like to go for a long walk on the beach? It depends on how long. Again, it's if it's a first date or if it's like the, you know, first 1 or 2 months of the relationship, then probably I would like to show the best of myself, right? So I would like to wear some high heels. So if I am wearing high heels, please don't ask me, let's go for a long walk. I wouldn't like it. Bowling'e gitmek. To go bowling. İlk buluşmamızda bowling'e gittik. İlk buluşmamızda bowling'e gittik. We went to bowling in our first date. Yeah, it's a good first date idea, I think, bowling. It was not very common in Turkey until recently, as far as I know, as far as my experience. And the word bowling, as you can see, we don't have the Turkish, actual Turkish word for it. So we kind of changed the English version to Turkish. We don't have W voice in Turkey, so that is why we made it V. So we say V. Ve voice, and it became bowling, bowling. Akvaryuma gitmek. To go to the aquarium. Deniz anılarını izlemek için akvaryuma gitmek istiyorum. deniz analarını izlemek için akvaryuma gitmek istiyorum. I want to go to aquarium to watch the jellyfish. It's a good idea. It's really nice, I think, date idea. Especially if your girlfriend is from somewhere like Ankara. They don't have sea, right? So maybe they are more curious about fish, sea. So aquarium is definitely a good idea. Operaya gitmek. To go to the opera. Sevgilimle operaya gitmek istiyorum ama biletler tükenmiş. Sevgilimle operaya gitmek istiyorum ama biletler tükenmiş. I want to go to the opera with my lover, but the tickets are sold out. That's too bad. But not just opera. I think musicals are also very interesting to go on a date. For example, I would be really happy if my lover would buy tickets for Harry Potter concert. You know, the symphony orchestra was playing Harry Potter music. That's a really nice idea to go on a date. Can you buy for me? Maybe you guys know where I'm from, right? Antalya. And in Antalya, during summer season, there is ballet and opera festival, and it is held in Aspendos, which is an ancient amphitheater. From all over the world, not just Turkey actually, also from Russia or other European countries, people are coming there, to Aspendos amphitheater to perform ballet and opera. So maybe if you're dating your girlfriend or boyfriend in the summer season in Antalya, it's a really nice idea to join this festival. It's very fun and very romantic. Hayvanat bahçesine gitmek. To go to the zoo. Hayvanat bahçesine gitmek istiyorsanız, sabah erken çıksanız iyi olur. Hayvanat bahçesine gitmek istiyorsanız, sabah erken çıksanız iyi olur. If you want to go to the zoo, you better wake up early in the morning. Well, if it's summertime, then like to go to zoo in afternoon would be really painful for you, I think, because it's so hot and you'll be outside all day. So yes, that's a good idea to wake up early. And there are so many animals to see, so waking up early is always a good idea when you're going to a date. Piknik yapmak. To have a picnic. Piknik yapmak için harika bir yer keşfettim. Piknik yapmak için harika bir yer keşfettim. I discovered a great place to have a picnic. Having a picnic, it's very common in Turkey, and not just for a date. Also, Turkish families really enjoy having a picnic with their family and children. So during picnic, we usually eat Turkish food, mostly Turkish breakfast, mostly. And also we play games like football, volleyball, and we listen music sometimes from the car because Turkish people, they come to the picnic with their cars and they open the doors and they open the music and then they listen while they're eating their food. It's really fun actually. And you can sit on the ground, or in some places in Turkey, some picnic places, they have tables, like wooden tables. So it depends on the place, but it's a really nice idea to go on a picnic. Akşam yemeği yemek ve film izlemek. To have dinner and see a movie. Cuma gecesi planımız güzel bir akşam yemeği yemek ve film izlemek. Cuma gecesi planımız güzel bir akşam yemeği yemek ve film izlemek. Our Friday night plan is to have a nice dinner and see a movie. It's a really good idea. I think it's my favorite in this list. So the movie, it's very important which one you choose. For example, if you're choosing a scary movie, oh, it's not okay for me. I don't like scary movies. Maybe a romantic movie would be nice, or a drama. Why not? So do you need my advice for a romantic Turkish movie? Let me give you one. It is called Kelebeğin Rüyası in Turkish, and in English, The Dream of a Butterfly. It's a really great movie. Romantic, very dramatic, very sad. So you will have all these emotions all together. It's about two young poets and their relationship with one girl, because they are searching for a girl who can influence them and who can let them write poems. It's a really interesting movie. Vapura binmek. To take a ferry ride. İstanbul'da vapura binmek çok romantik bir etkinlik olabilir. İstanbul'da vapura binmek çok romantik bir etkinlik olabilir. Taking a ferry ride in Istanbul could turn out to be a very romantic event. It's pretty romantic, if you ask me. So, you can just take a ferry ride with your girlfriend, boyfriend, with your lover. And then, do you know the Turkish bread, simit? Just buy some simit. And then you can feed seagulls. Do you know seagulls? You just feed them and talk with your lover. Hey, like, how are you? It's pretty romantic. Müzeye gitmek. To go to the museum. Hoşlandığım çocuğa birlikte müzeye gitmeyi teklif etmeyi düşünüyorum. Ama sıkıcı bulabileceğinden korkuyorum. Hoşlandığım çocuğa birlikte müzeye gitmeyi teklif etmeyi düşünüyorum. Ama sıkıcı bulabileceğinden korkuyorum. I'm thinking about asking the boy I like to go to the museum together, but I'm afraid he may find it boring. Not most of the museums are boring, I don't think so. There are some really nice art museums. For example, in Turkey, Istanbul, there is Istanbul Modern Art Museum, and they have exhibitions about contemporary art, and it's really fun, very interesting. So, keep that in mind.
Nice.
Yes, Hatra. Yes. This is all for today. I hope I could give you some ideas about a romantic date in Turkey or in Turkish. So tell me your ideas and try to say in Turkish. I will read your comments. And please don't forget to visit TurkishClass101.com. So please subscribe our channel. And I hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.
Merhaba, hi, I'm Seda. Welcome to TurkishClass101.com. Today we'll talk about 5 sentences you want to hear when going out with someone. Okay, let's start. The first one. Seni tekrar ne zaman görebilirim? Seni tekrar ne zaman görebilirim? When can I see you again? Ooh, that's always nice to hear. Yeah, of course. The next one, especially really good to hear, I think for a woman, I don't know, for men as well. Harika görünüyorsun. Harika görünüyorsun. You look wonderful. Who doesn't want to hear that? The third one is, çok güzel bir akşam oldu. Çok güzel bir akşam oldu. This was a great evening. Wow, that's always good. And for both of you, I think, not just to hear it, but just to experience it, if it was a great night, you know? And the fourth one is senden hoşlanıyorum. Senden hoşlanıyorum. I've got a crush on you. Yeah, I think this is maybe before going out. You know, you say that then you go out, but you'll never know. Sometimes you hear on the day, right? Okay. And the fifth one, the last one is, this is too much, but biz birlikte olmak için yaratılmışız. Biz birlikte olmak için yaratılmışız. Biz birlikte olmak için yaratılmışız. We are meant to be together. Wow, this is so epic. Okay, I don't know which one would you like to hear? You know, I would prefer maybe the first one and the second one, you know. When can I see you again? Or you look great. These are more casual sentences. The others are... And the third one is also okay, but the others... Maybe not for the first date. I don't know. Okay, what do you think? Which one would you prefer hearing it when you go out with someone? Please leave some comments below and I will see you the next time. Bye! Bye! Bye, Blunt! Bye!
Want to speed up your language learning? Take your very first lesson with us. You'll start speaking in minutes and master real conversations. Sign up for your free lifetime account. Just click the link in the description.